you. Thanks for being with RT. Sean Hoare's death is being described by police tonight as unexplained but not suspicious. However, you know, it's another bizarre twist, no matter how you look at it, isn't it, in this continuing scandal going right to the heart of power in Britain. I mean, do you think the conspiracy theorists will be on overdrive now?
Well, I don't know about the conspiracy theorists, but I think certainly it would be prudent to take a look at the timing and nature of this death, just considering the timing with which it's unfolding. And I think this actually goes to the very heart of the scandal that's unfolding, because it really does raise the question of what institution can be trusted with an investigation into this death. Certainly the London Metropolitan Police is in shambles at the moment, with the commissioner and assistant commissioner having resigned over the scandal already, and obviously implicated with some of their police officers, obviously, in this scandal. And then also the idea of there being some sort of parliamentary inquiry into a suspicious death would be highly suspect, because obviously Andy Coulson was the former communication minister for the prime minister, and he's the one implicated by Sean Hoare's testimony. So it goes to the very heart of the depth of the scandal that we're dealing with, in which I think the public has every right to be skeptical of these institutions which are supposedly going to be investigating themselves in these matters.
James, I don't know how much you know about this deceased man, Sean Hoare. I mean, how important a figure was he in the revelations about phone hacking?
I don't know in the overall scheme. Perhaps he wasn't the most important linchpin of the investigation, but just the idea that he was coming out with these revelations and winding up dead just as this scandal is unfolding, I think the timing in itself is suspicious, and I think the public would be best served by a full and independent inquiry into that death. But given the nature of, for example, the Hutton inquiry into Dr. David Kelly's death, I'm not sure how much the public can even trust such an inquiry.
Well, talking of trust, Britain's two top cops have both resigned since the weekend over links to News of the World figures being investigated by the police over this whole hacking scandal. I mean, have the police lost the trust of the British public over their handling of it so far?
I would think so, and I think deservedly so, to find out that certain officers had been on the payroll of these organizations and providing details to the journalists who were involved in this scandal. That in itself is quite a disgrace, and it does raise the question of who is properly qualified to look into this and to form a proper investigation. Certainly not the police itself investigating itself. That would be ridiculous at this point, and the idea, again, of a parliamentary inquiry, it has to be at least seem to be completely free of ties to the Prime Minister's office, certainly, and to any other MPs who may have been implicated in the scandal. So it's going to be an incredible mess, unfortunately, for the British people to be sorting through right now. And I think trust in the public institutions has been necessarily eroded by this appalling, disgraceful conduct on the part of so many different people in whom the public has invested so much trust.
Well, you just mentioned there the British PM, David Cameron. Just to recap for our viewers, I'm sure they already know, but just to recap, he of course hired the former News of the World editor Andy Coulson as his PR man. How might this affair affect him politically now, Cameron?
I think he has to be at least somewhat tarnished by this affair. I think there may be a possibility that he'll come through on the other side vindicated, but just to have been, I think, so deeply involved in this and to have exposed really the fact that not only, of course, Cameron, but numerous prime ministers before him have had a very cozy relationship, to say the least, with News of the World and with various Murdoch operations, and not only his relationship to Andy Coulson, but to Rebecca Brooks, the recently resigned and recently arrested CEO of News of the World. I mean, it's a very difficult situation for him to extract himself from or to claim that he had no idea of what was going on.
James, the Murdoch media empire had, didn't it, unrivaled political influence in Britain. Its reputation, though, is now in tatters. Could the role that Murdoch once had be filled by another media organization or mogul looking ahead?
I think definitely there will be a power vacuum if Murdoch does vacate, or obviously Murdoch's newspapers will be tarnished by this. So I think there will be a power vacuum, and unfortunately vacuums tend to be filled quite quickly. So I would imagine that there will be other people and other organizations come along to take his place quite quickly. And we see, it's interesting to see the timing of this scandal just as he was applying for control of BSkyB.
You're looking in on this story from Japan, where you're based. Interesting to get your take on why you think this case has caused such particular outrage.
I think it goes to the heart of a number of different things, and one of them is just the idea of this this phone hacking, and the idea that we're all vulnerable to this, and in our times of greatest vulnerability, in the times of a death of a loved one, or the 7/7 bombing victims, for example, being hacked into like that, it's the most incredible intrusion of people's privacy that I think really horrifies people. And it's interesting to see how people get horrified in this circumstance, but not in the circumstance of, for example, when the British government comes out and says they're tapping the phones of 1,000 citizens per day, as they did back in 2008. There was a report released about that, or the illegal wiretapping going on in the United States.
Yeah, no, when that program headlines, were there?
No. It's very interesting to see people are quite sanguine when it's the government doing it. But at least in this case, it is sparking a public debate. And I think, again, it is the revulsion at the idea of the intrusion of people's basic privacy.
All right, James Corbett, independent news website editor. A pleasure to have you on RT. Thank you.